Hello, welcome to sutasty. This time we talk about iron absorption in the gastrointestinal tract. Iron is an essential trace mineral needed by our bodies. Iron is a principal constituent of blood as an essential part of hemoglobin in red blood cells. Hemoglobin is the protein containing heme iron in the blood cells. About two-thirds of our body's iron is in hemoglobin. Iron exists in hemoglobin as a heme iron complex, which gives the blood red color. Heme iron is a five-member nitrogen-containing ring molecule with a cage around the central ferrous iron ion. The hemoglobin of the red blood cells in the bloodstream binds oxygen in the lungs, transports oxygen to body cells and carries carbon dioxide away from cells for elimination by the lungs. Heme iron also exists in myoglobin. Myoglobin is the principal constituent of muscles. Myoglobin is a muscle protein providing oxygen to muscles for muscle contraction. Next, we discuss briefly the factors affecting iron absorption. The iron in the food consumed isn't absorbed into the bloodstream very efficiently. The quantity of iron that the body can absorb depends on the following factors. The amount of iron the body has already stored in the body. The iron form, whether the iron is heme iron or nonheme iron. Heme iron is from the animal meat source, whereas nonheme iron comes from plant food sources such as leafy green vegetables and whole grain baked goods. Heme iron is the iron form contained in meat, poultry, and fish. Heme iron is the heme group in hemoglobin and myoglobin proteins in animal meats. Nonheme iron is the iron in plant origin foods. Interestingly, egg yolks have mostly nonheme iron. Usually, heme ions can be absorbed more readily than nonheme iron. The iron absorption also depends on the existence and amount of other substances which may enhance or hinder the absorption of nonheme iron. The presence of heme iron enhances the absorption of nonheme iron, however, nonheme iron cannot affect heme iron absorption. Heme iron is absorbed more readily than nonheme iron is. Depending on the amount of iron the body has stored, 15% to 35% of heme iron from food gets absorbed. Even though foods with nonheme iron often contain more iron, only 2% to 20% of nonheme iron gets absorbed. The bioavailability of iron in a mixed diet, animal and plant-based foods, is about 18%. Iron from the diet is first absorbed into the intestinal mucosal cells. Then the iron is transported from the mucosal cells to the rest of the body, depending on needs. Now, let us talk about the iron absorption in the gastrointestinal tract. Our bodies are highly adaptive, absorbing more iron when their iron stores are low and less when iron storage is higher. After intake, iron from the diet is first absorbed into the intestinal mucosal cells. The amount of iron transported from the mucosal cells to the rest of the body depends on need. If body stores of iron are high, less iron is transported from the mucosal cells to the tissues. If iron stores are low, a more significant percentage of the iron that has been absorbed into the mucosal cells is transported to tissues in need of iron. The amount of iron transported from the mucosal cells to the rest of the body depends on needs. If body stores of iron are high, less iron is transported from the mucosal cells. Three proteins regulate the delivery and transport of iron in the body. The three proteins are the copper-containing protein ceruloplasmin, the iron transport protein transferrin, and the iron storage protein ferritin. Ceruloplasmin converts ferrous iron to ferric iron, and the ferric iron ion can bind to transferrin and ferritin. The iron that has entered the mucosal cells of the small intestine can be bound to ferritin or picked up and transported by transferrin through the bloodstream to the liver, bones, and other body tissues. In body tissues, transferrin receptors on cell membranes bind to the transferrin iron complex, allowing it to enter the cell where the iron is released for use. Our bodies are intelligent in adjusting iron absorption through the dynamic balancing of iron storage and transport proteins and the protein receptors on the cell membrane. When iron is in short supply, less of the iron storage protein ferritin is made. In the meantime, the number of transferrin receptors on cell membranes increases, allowing more iron to be transported into the cells. On the other hand, more iron storage protein, ferritin, is made to increase storage capacity when the iron is plentiful. Simultaneously, the number of transferrin receptors on cell membranes decreases, therefore, a decreased amount of iron picked up from the mucosal cells and transported to tissues can enter the cells. The iron that is not picked up from mucosal cells is excreted in the feces along with mucosal cells when they die and are sloughed off into the intestinal lumen. The iron absorbed over immediate needs can be stored in the protein ferritin, primarily in the liver, spleen, and bone marrow. When ferritin concentrations in the liver become high, some is converted to an insoluble storage protein called hemosiderin. The bound iron can be mobilized from body stores as needed. Sutasty made this video. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.